we're recording. Hey there, YouTube, my name's Kirby is a Boss. Welcome to my room, welcome to my channel, and today I'm going to be doing a Christian book haul. Now, if you know anything about me, if you follow me on Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, all those things, you know that I am an avid book reader. Quarantine really hasn't been that bad for me because I've actually had more time to just sit back, relax, read a good book, not only grow intellectually, but spiritually. Now, if I were to actually show my entire book collection, we would be here for probably about an hour long video. I'm just going to show 10 of them to you guys. So if you want a part two to this video, give this video a thumbs up and comment down below. Anyways, let's get on into this video. Remember to subscribe because I put out new videos every other week. And now let's get to reading. The first book that I want to recommend is To Hell with the Hustle by Jefferson Bethke. This book is phenomenal. It is all about rest. It is all about the Sabbath. And I think it's really timely for this season, specifically with everything going on with the pandemic and with quarantine. This helped me personally reprioritize how I am pursuing my time and if I'm giving it to the Lord or if I'm just trying to fill it up because I've made time an idol. It helps you with setting up boundaries and cultivating discipline in your life, as well as understanding why you're doing what you're doing and if you're really doing it for the Lord and how to honor him through rest as well. So yes, get your hands on this book. Jefferson Bethke is also a phenomenal communicator. So it's written in a very fun way. But yeah, this is the first book that I want y'all to check out. The second book that I want you guys to check out is actually a devotional by my friend Chelsea Crockett, now Chelsea Hurst, but it's called Above All Else. This is specifically a 60-day devotional for young women. I walked through and I did this devotional, and what I love about it is that not only is it just giving you a good verse and information, but it encourages you to dive deep, to think about it for yourself, to apply it to your life. And honestly, I'm one of those people that doesn't just love, oh, this is what this verse spoke to me, but I also love biblical context. And she adds a lot of that in here. So you're really getting a lot out of it. But yeah, get your hand on this. The third book I want to recommend is kind of a deep read. So if you're one of those people that really loves intellectual, kind of philosophical almost thinking, then you need to read my boy C.S. Lewis, The Problem of Pain. This book, it's one of those books where it's like I have to read the chapter twice because I'm like, what? It is so well thought out, and it is just, it explores basically, to put it in short, why would a good and loving sovereign God allow evil and suffering to happen, especially to those who are innocent? Now, I know this is a question that I get asked a lot. It also explores God's sovereignty and free will. So this book just hits so many theological topics. This is a very challenging read. It's a great read, a thought-invoking read. And in my systematic theology class, I use this for my exegetical research paper. So a lot of good info in this one. The fourth book I want to recommend, this is a really popular one that circulated through the Christian community, is Single, Dating, Engaged, Married by Ben Stewart, Navigating Life and Love in the Modern Age. Bruh. When I say that this book helped me so much with understanding the purpose of specifically dating, engagement, and marriage, y'all, this book really gave me a lot of peace in understanding the roles between a man and a woman in a relationship in all stages of life. It outlines the biblical principles and how God sees us individually and what that covenant looks like when we come together. This is a great book. Now, the fifth book that I have recommended for you guys is great if you just want to read it on your own, if you want to do it maybe as a devotional study, or if maybe you have a discipleship group or a community group that meets every week. This is a great book to go through together. It's called A Shepherd Looks at Psalm 23 by W. Philip Keller. Now, it's a little tiny book, so maybe you just want a quick little read. This is great. But basically, it goes through Psalm 23, very short chapter in the book of Psalm. It's that one really famous psalm, you know, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. All of that, right? But it breaks it down verse by verse and what that means, because it talks about how God is our shepherd. But it brings in that cultural context and that imagery, and it brings it into our understanding of what those original readers would have known about that lifestyle, about that time. My community group, we went through this specifically. We went through every verse when we met up for however long it took, however many verses it was, however many weeks. And it was phenomenal. It really impacted me in the season that I was in and drawing into a deeper intimacy with the Lord. So get your hands on this. I love this. This is phenomenal. The sixth book that I have for you all is called God's Promises and Answers for Your Life. What this book is, oh, a card, how fun. But with this book, it has different prompts. So if you go to the very beginning, it's like what the Bible has to say about faith, love, eternity, praise, truth from the Bible about forgiving others, Christian fellowship, gives you scripture that talks about this. Now, of course you could Google those things and that's good and fine too, but this is one of the earliest books that I actually have when I first gave my life to the Lord. So this is just a little good tool to have in your arsenal. But yeah, God's Promises and Answers. My seventh book is specifically curated towards women, so sorry guys, you can skip this one if you want, but it's called True Feelings, God's Gracious and Glorious Purpose for Our Emotions by Carolyn Mahaney and Nicole Whitaker. This book, again, not to, you know, get all crazy and tell you guys about a season that I recently came out of, but I was dealing with a lot of emotional baggage, and I again was trying to overcome and figure out and process my feelings and emotions, just because it's easy for me to put my emotions aside and focus on what I need to get done, what I need to do, what's ahead of me, but then all my emotions, they stack up. And it's like they fall down and it's like, I don't even know what I feel anymore. I feel everything all at once and I don't know how to honor God with my emotions, because God gave us emotions, right? And this book was a very practical way of walking through scripture and showing me how to process my emotions and my feelings properly as a woman, how to submit them before the Lord, and how to honor God in that way. And I've done. That I want to introduce to you all is an apologetics book. So I've been showing this on my Instagram story for a while now, but it's called Cold Case Christianity, and it's by J. Warner Wallace. And basically, it's this homicide detective's journey through exploring if the gospel cases are valid. So this homicide detective, basically he was an atheist for the longest time, and he took on the challenge to see, okay, is there actually reason behind these claims about Jesus Christ being who he was in the Bible being true? So it's very similar to, you know, Lee Strobel, kind of like his journey with, you know, the case for Christ. Rice Brooks also wrote the foreword to this along with Lee Strobel, but this is great. Not only does this provide a lot of, I don't want to say ammunition, but a lot of facts whenever you're doing apologetics, but again, it's written in a way that's very interesting. He talks about like being a homicide detective and about how he did things while he was on the case and how he applied that to seeing if Christianity was valid and how he came to the point that it's an undeniable truth. That's the book that you need to get your hands on. All right, we're almost done. The ninth book that I want to recommend is Emotionally Healthy Spirituality, the updated edition. And basically, it's all about how we need to be emotionally mature in order to be spiritually mature, and explores different ways that we are emotionally unhealthy, or areas that we are not emotionally healthy, and that affects our spiritual walk with the Lord. So again, let's get emotionally right while we're in quarantine, and get your hands on this book, because I guarantee you that there's an area of your life that you need to work on that's covered in this book. But it's really good. It really tests you, and it calls out things within you. It's a very refining book, but it brings you closer to the Lord again. So good. The last book that I want to share with you all is actually a textbook that I got when I was in university, but it's called The Promises and the Blessings, A Historical Survey on the Old and New Testament by Michael A. Harbin. And it's so good because it provides so much historical and cultural context throughout the entire Bible. So if you're one of those people that's wanting to get more exegetical when it comes to your Bible studies, or if you're sermon writing, or if you want to be a youth group leader, or, you know, have some sort of leadership or understanding of scripture to the degree in which it was written and to who it was written to, this is great. But yeah, it really covers the whole Bible. That's what it's all about. So yeah, The Promises and the Blessings. Great book. I hope those 10 books really help you guys out, but I hope you guys have a blessed week. I hope that you're staying safe during everything going on in quarantine. And with all that being said, remember to keep on keeping on, and I'll catch you guys on the flip side. Stay stellar.